next, it's a flyweight matchup between Henry Cejudo and Chico the King Camus. Chico Camus, very focused and prepared for this fight. He's had a great training camp, and he feels he cannot be defeated.
This guy has excellent footwork. He's very difficult to catch inside the octagon. He closes the distance well, and he's always in a position to attack and defend.
Chico Camus enters the octagon, and he's ready to fight. Henry Cejudo, looking very confident as he makes his way out to the octagon. He is ready to go.
This guy has lightning-fast hand speed. His combinations come swiftly and from all angles.
Set to fight Chico Camus. Our tale of the tape for this flyweight fight. Cejudo is 29. Camus is 31. Cejudo will have a 1-inch reach advantage. And with the official introductions, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC flyweight division. A mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 14 wins, 7 losses, and 1 no contest. He stands 5 feet 6 inches tall, weighing in at 125 pounds. Fighting out of Milwaukee, Wisconsin, Chico the King Camus! And now, introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a Greco-Roman wrestler holding a professional record of 10 wins, no losses. He stands 5 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 125 pounds. Fighting out of Phoenix, Arizona, Henry the Messenger Cejudo! And when the action begins, a referee in charge, Herb Dean.
Herb Dean, our referee.
Let's fight. Ready.
And here we go. Fight scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. White trunks for Camus. Black trunks for Cejudo. He avoided damage blocking the big kick. Oh, he tagged him with that hook to the head. Camus with the combination.
Big swing and a miss.
To the body.
Swinging early, both men.
He is really finding his range with that uppercut.
For sure.
He just missed him. He's finding his rhythm here early in the round.
Very nice timing with these shots here.
Joe, he might be looking to set up that uppercut again.
Looking for the single.
And he's got the takedown. Got the reversal.
Back up.
Big scores with a huge left.
What a jab.
Oh, combination. Big shots. Oh, that hook did damage. Oh, Joe, another strong jab.
Vicious combinations.
Cejudo with a jab. Wow, what a great job mixing things up. Solid overhand by Camus.
And a nice 1-2.
Wow!
To the right and the left.
Oh! Unbelievable! It is all over!
tremendous hook on the button for the win.
Time now for our fight replay.
And as we can see here in the replay, it was the hook that ended this fight. There it is again. Check it out again. Boom! Out cold.
Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 59 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Henry the Messenger Cejudo.
Henry Cejudo, winner by knockout.
Between Tisha Torres and Alexandra Stitch Albu.
Alexandra Albu, as always, very well prepared, extremely focused, and ready to go to battle.
This girl is a really well-rounded fighter, a full and complete mixed martial artist with an arsenal of techniques from Muay Thai, kickboxing, jiu-jitsu, judo, wrestling, boxing. She can really do it all. So very unpredictable in that regard and very comfortable no matter where the fight goes.
Torres. She is set to go to battle tonight inside the octagon. Her ultimate goal is to be a UFC champion, but she is very focused on tonight's opponent, and she knows that this may very well be the toughest test of her mixed martial arts career. That said, she guarantees that she will leave with her arm raised tonight.
This girl has outstanding hand speed, lightning fast punches that come from all angles, and she gets out of the way before you can hit her back. She's one of the most difficult fighters to face in this division.
Our tale of the tape for this strawweight showdown.
This is a very even matchup. Everything between these two fighters tonight is virtually identical. And now with our official introductions, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC strawweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This woman is a mixed martial artist on a professional record of 6 wins, no losses. She stands 5'2" tall, weighing in at 115 pounds. Sandra Stitch Albu. And now introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner. A kickboxer holding a professional record of 7 wins, no losses. She stands 5'1" tall, weighing in at 115 pounds. Fighting out of Fort Lauderdale, Florida, USA, Tisha the Tiny Tornado Torres.
And when the referee is Mario Yamasaki. Mike Goldberg, Joe Rogan, we are set for the start of round number one. Tonight's fight is scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. White trunks for Albu, black trunks for Torres. Nice job with the roundhouse.
Good body punch there.
And they're battling here early. Her striking is outstanding tonight. Albu with a good right kick to the body.
Oh, nice body shot. Very good
job of timing these punches.
That huge head kick was blocked.
There it is. Oh, look at that. Beautiful hook.
Oh!
Oh! What an exchange!
Big punches here.
Nice takedown.
Really good movement on the ground. 3 minutes remain in the round. Nice roundhouse kick.
And she's down!
Beautiful leg kicks.
Oh, big head kick. Oh, solid jab.
Able to pass to half guard.
Win the scramble. Win the scramble.
Hammer fist.
Good leg kick.
Good shot.
He's been busy.
Oh, beautiful combination.
Joshi again scores with the uppercut. That seems to be her go-to punch. Elbow with a strong hook to the body. Joshi's been very effective with the uppercut. She's going to look to establish it again here. Kick misses.
Good punch. There's that uppercut we were calling for.
Great takedown defense right there. Very nicely done.
Just under a minute on the clock here in the round.
Looks for that front kick, but missed it.
Good right left combo.
Man. Hard hook. Whoa! Hard diving punch.
Nice round with the huge knockdown from Alexandra Albers.
Yeah, that was a big moment in that round and probably the most significant aspect of the round.
Here's a vicious kick that results in a knockdown.
Let's check that out from a different angle. And let's check it out from a different angle.
Carly getting us set for round two.
Here you go, second round, you ready? You ready?
Let's second go, round. Left, right. Southpaw stance.
Beautiful spinning back kick to the body.
Oh, that's a big head kick.
Oh, beautiful.
Powerful strikes. Superman punch.
Nice jab. Oh, what a combination.
Oh, that's a big kick.
Oh, head kick.
Over the top. Combination.
Beautiful body shot there, too. Nasty combinations here.
Big straight punch.
Nice inside leg kick.
Her other eye is starting to swell now.
Nicely stuffed.
We've reached the midway point of this fight.
Stop the takedown again.
Half guard.
Wow, look at that.
How good is that?
Uh-oh. Here's a little piece of trivia for folks who don't know. The reason why you're not allowed to do a downward elbow, 12 to 6, is because when they first brought mixed martial arts to athletic commissions, the people on the commission said, well, you can't let someone do that.
She's going after the rear naked choke. Wants to slide that forearm under the chin to get the choke.
Oh,
it looks pretty deep. That's it.
It is all over.
Set up the choke, completed the job, and got the victory.
Once again, here's our fight replay.
Let's see it again here. Got the choke. It's in deep. And no choice but to tap. And here we can see it again. That's a real tight choke here. And here we see it again. Beautiful submission victory.
With the official decision, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Mario Yamasaki has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 40 seconds of round number 2. Declaring the winner by tap out, Tisha the Tiny Tornado Torres.
Tisha Torres earns the win by submission.
It's a middleweight matchup between Kelvin Gastelum and Nate the Great Parkour. Nate Parkour ready to go to battle once again inside the octagon.
This guy has an amazing ability to control fighters from the top position. Once he gets there, that is where the fight will remain.
Nate Parkour is set for tonight's fight. Season 17 of The Ultimate Fighter, Kelvin Gastelum, who made Ultimate Fighter history by becoming the youngest ever fighter to earn the moniker of being the Ultimate Fighter.
Kelvin Gastelum combines heart, will, determination, cardio, and outstanding wrestling, and all of those made for a successful combination when he won the UFC's Ultimate Fighter.
Kelvin Gastelum, looking for another UFC win. Our tale of the tape for this middleweight fight. Gastelum is 24. Marquardt is 36. He will have a 3-inch reach advantage. Once again, here's the veteran voice of the octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC middleweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is an ex-martial artist, holding a professional record of 37 wins, 15 losses, and 2 draws. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Fighting out of Denver, Colorado, Nate the Great Marquardt. And now, fighting at the red corner. Mixed martial artist holding the professional record of 11 wins, 2 losses. He stands 5 feet 9 inches tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Fighting out of Yuma, Arizona, USA.
Eve Levine, our referee, for this middleweight bout here tonight at Saitama Super Arena in Tokyo, Japan.
Fight scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds.
White trunks for Marquardt, black trunks for Gastelum.
Marquardt is the 7-time King of Pancrase. He's extremely well-rounded, very powerful, and has competed against the best in the world for years. He's held titles in several organizations, and he still seems to improve every time we see him.
Joe, he continues to put together great combinations. Strong hook to the body by Gastelum. Good right-left combination.
He clipped him with that one.
And fourth.
Looking for the single.
Marquardt caught by that inside leg kick. Nice jab.
These guys are going at it here right away, trading blows.
Marquardt with a good leg kick. Nice hook to the body.
Another good
strike. There's another one.
You can hear that one. Oh, he's starting to tee off.
Oh, he's good. He kicks.
Wow. Huge kick. Oh, that one
big
hurt.
Shot.
Good combination.
Oh. He got rocked big time.
He's in big, big trouble.
Hard straight punch. Oh, he's landing. Oh!
That's
huge,
a solid hook.
Big punches.
Whoa! Here is the big uppercut that led to the knockout. He had been throwing that uppercut throughout the fight, but this last one was the one that led to the KO. Check it out again. Look at this. Right on the button.
Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 40 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Kelvin Gastelum.
Kelvin Gastelum, victorious with the knockout.
Lightweight matchup between Gilbert El Nino Melendez and Eddie Alvarez.
Eddie Alvarez coming off a great training camp and feels outstanding.
This guy can keep a pace that very few human beings can match. His cardio is absolutely outstanding.
Eddie Alvarez steps inside the octagon, and he's ready to fight. Melendez, who for years has been amongst the elite in mixed martial arts. He was 11-1 during his days in Strikeforce, earned the lightweight championship on 2 occasions. Always willing to stand in the middle of the octagon and trade, he's a Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt under Cesar Gracie. Gilbert El Nino Melendez.
Gilbert Melendez, the former Strikeforce lightweight champion, is one of the elite at 155 pounds. He has outstanding cardio, devastating knockout power, excellent wrestling, and success over top-notch fighters.
Our tale of the tape for this lightweight collision. What an even matchup. Everything between these two fighters tonight is virtually identical. And with the official introductions, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC lightweight division. Introducing first, fighting at the blue corner. This man is a freestyle fighter, holding a professional record of 27 wins, 4 losses. He stands 5 feet 9 inches tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting out of Boca Raton, Florida, Eddie Alvarez! And now, introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. A mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 22 wins, 5 losses. He stands 5 feet 9 inches tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting out of San Francisco, California, USA, Gilbert!
Dan Mergliotta, our referee.
Okay, you ready? You ready?
And we are underway. Fight scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. White trunks for Rumble. Black trunks for Melendez. Good jab.
Welcome to the jungle.
Good 1-2 combo by Alvarez.
Very nice shots landing.
Big hook. Punishing roundhouse kick.
Big kick, but miss.
Precise straight right by Alvarez.
Nice front kick to the body.
That's a solid straight. He's in a better position here with the tie clinch. He changes his stance.
Jab.
Alvarez with the strong combination. Landing it will.
Nice left hook to the body.
Powerful suplex.
That's some wrestling right there.
Nice job avoiding the leg kick.
Push kick. Great exchanges. Very nice kicks. He's doing a great job of being unpredictable and mixing things up here.
Nice knee.
Beautiful left hook.
Good job blocking the punch. Looking for another takedown.
He's in half guard here.
Looking for the head kick. Alvarez with the jab. Nice.
Nice 1-2.
Looking for the takedown.
Oh, nasty slam.
How good was that?
Nice jab.
He's landing an outstanding leg kick. Big roundhouse kick. Completes the
suplex. Takedown. It appears a cut has opened up on his cheek.
Good safe defense for now.
Nice inside leg kick. Missed that shot.
Solid straight by Melendez.
Leg kick. They are exchanging here, Mike.
That's a nice right-left combo by Melendez.
Stuffed it. Stuffed it.
We're going to take him down again. And Joe, there's another nice takedown. Outstanding job with the takedowns tonight. Round one in the books.
Here we see a beautiful takedown. And here's another perfectly executed takedown.
And here's another very nice takedown.
All right, it's starting to swell. Your eyes starting to blow up, all right? It's fine, man. All right? Just don't worry.
The lovely Carly.
Okay, round two, you ready? You ready?
Second round. Joe, the story of that last round, Gilbert Melendez's leg kicks.
Tremendous leg kicks landed in that round. Thunderous. And without a doubt, his opponent's got to start checking some of those.
And he looks for the takedown.
Huge slam! Great punch by Alvarez.
And he winds up on top.
Joe, there we see our total strikes landed.
Oh, huge suplex!
Melendez's left eye looks like it's really starting to swell up here.
In full guard here. Big punch from the bottom.
And here comes over the top to the head. Alvarez going to work from his guard.
Oh, big right hand clipped him. Oh, this fight's close to being stopped.
Great head kick. Big straight punch.
Huge slam. Nice takedown.
Lot of time
he's
left,
in a
Joe.
Position where he's going to get armbarred here. He's got to be very careful. He's got the arm here. Now he's going to throw his leg over.
And he got it out. Alvarez with the punch that connects.
Hip escape. Gets out of the full mount.
Side control.
Nicely done.
Joe, I wouldn't be surprised if he looks to try to set up another takedown.
He's doing a great job of controlling the center of the octagon and keeping his opponent on the outside.
Caught him with a punch.
Good back and forth battle.
He's doing a great job of timing these shots.
Melendez gets nailed by that head kick.
Nice knee to the body.
Good defense, and he counters with a jab.
Tagged him.
Gilbert Melendez is not effectively using his reach advantage tonight.
He's certainly not using that reach advantage. What he's doing is fighting like a guy who's much shorter than he actually is.
That cut on his face is really deep, and the blood is really starting to pour out. Alvarez with the good kick to the body.
Punch to the head.
That'll do it for round number two.
Here's a big leg kick. Here's a powerful leg kick. And here you see excellent technique and a big slam.
The lovely Ariane here tonight in Tokyo, Japan.
Last round, guys. You ready? You ready?
Let's go fight. Third and final round.
Excellent feint with the kick.
Melendez gets hit with that kick to the midsection. Solid jab by Alvarez.
That's huge, a beautiful shot with the hook. Oh! Solid straight left. Hard straight punch.
Oh, he's landing at will. Oh, big kicks. They're scoring. Wow! Man, he's in big trouble here.
Wow! Unbelievable! That's it. He's out. He's out.
What power that guy has in his hands.
Let's check out the action on our fight replay.
Let's take a look at the replay. This is the shot that drops him. Perfect technique. He's clearly hurt badly here. Let's take a look at it one more time. Here's the knockdown. Vicious strike. Great angle here. Boom! And that is all she wrote.
Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 57 seconds of round number 3. Declaring the winner by knockout, Eddie Alvarez!
Eddie Alvarez wins by knockout.
It's a heavyweight collision between Cain Velasquez and top-level submission fighter Fabricio Werdum. Fabricio Werdum making his way to the octagon with just UFC heavyweight champion.
As he makes his way towards the cage, his preparation has been perfect. He is in fantastic shape, had an amazing camp, and he believes that he is in the perfect position to become the new champion of the world. As he steps into the octagon right now, he steps in with a champion's mindset.
Fabricio Werdum enters the octagon with one goal, leaving as the champion. Velasquez making his way to the octagon looking to defend his belt.
Cain Velasquez can keep a pace that very few heavyweights can match. His cardio is incredible, his work ethic is second to none, and his wrestling is top notch.
Set to fight Fabricio by Cavallo Werdum. Our tale of the tape for this heavyweight championship fight. The American is 33. The Brazilian is 38. He is 3 inches taller. The reach is identical. And with the official introductions, here's the veteran voice of the octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Herb D. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the Saitama Super Arena in Tokyo. This man is a Muay Thai kickboxer and jiu-jitsu fighter, holding a professional record of 20 wins, 5 losses, and 1 draw. He stands 6 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 239 pounds. Fighting out of Los Angeles, California, USA, presenting the challenger, Fabricio! And now introducing the champion, fighting
out of the red corner.
This man is a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 13 wins, 2 losses. He stands 6 feet 1 inch tall, weighing in at 240 pounds. Fighting out of San Jose, California, ladies and gentlemen, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world, King!
All right, this is for the championship. You can give me your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves. Let's make it official.
Cain Velasquez. Ready to fight. Fabricio Verdun. Here we go! Championship fight scheduled for 5 5-minute rounds. White trunks for Verdun. Black trunks for the champion. Joe, we have seen many title fights over the year, but few have been as much anticipated as this matchup. Bad blood back and forth, two of the best fighters ever to compete in the octagon. Only one man will leave with the belt.
The time is here. We've been waiting for this for a long time. The fans are hyped up, and this is one of the most highly anticipated world championship fights ever. An absolutely enormous fight right now. Side control, working from the mounted crucifix. Inside control once again. Oh, head kick.
With the kick. That's a big hook.
Oh, he's landed some good shots here.
Oh, nice kick.
The champ is in deep danger here. He's really hurt, and he is going to lose his title if he can't recover.
Huge takedown. What a suplex.
He eats a high one. Clean jab. Both men landing in that exchange.
Big shot. And Joe, you and I both know that Cain Velasquez has the skills to knock anybody out. Velasquez gets caught by the head kick. That's another big head kick, Joe. I don't know how many more his opponent can take.
Fabricio Verdun with some serious body shots.
Absolutely, Joe. Punishing shots to the body. Nice striking. Solid leg kick by Velasquez.
Hit him with the jab.
Verdun with the combination.
Steps forward with his right leg. Now he's in southpaw. Oh, flying knee. Oh, he's going for it here. Wow, he is throwing some huge kicks here.
Big power jab. Combination. Oh!
Nasty right hand.
10 seconds.
There he is. Got the takedown.
Into the round. And that was a huge takedown that will score points.
Here's a nasty knee that does damage. And here's a flying knee that lands perfectly. And here we see a devastating suplex.
Hey, listen. Don't worry about it. I'm telling you right now.
Carly getting us set for round two. Poised, determined to leave with the belt. Man, the left side of the body continues to get worse, and it's because of all those great strikes.
Knee to the body by the champ.
Here we see the number of leg kicks landed thus far.
There's a nice left hand.
Oh, he sweeps. Look at his position now.
Side control.
Nicely done.
Excellent movement on the ground here. Constantly moving, constantly staying busy. Working from side control. Escape. He's got full guard here.
Verdum with a good punt.
Under 2 minutes on the clock here.
Oh, he tagged him with that straight. Another solid head strike by Verdum.
Good sprawl. Good sprawl here.
Strong jab by Velasquez.
Oh, he's got him down.
Nice sweep.
Looking for the rear naked.
Under a minute on the clock here in round two.
He's free from the rear naked choke.
Nice sweep. He's a full guard.
Right to half guard.
Looks like he's got a submission locked up. He popped out of the triangle.
The huge head kick is blocked.
Gonna head to round three.
And there's a nice head kick that lands. And here's another head kick. And here's one more perfectly placed head kick.
The beautiful Ariani.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Good. And we are set for the start of round three. This is a championship fight, so it is scheduled for five-minute rounds.
That was a nice jab.
Man, so much punishment done to the body tonight. Look at the bruising. Great defense. Good block, straight counter.
Nice brawl.
Verdum with a solid right kick to the body.
Nice left hand.
Joe, he's keeping very busy. Look at the numbers. Total strikes line.
He's got the double.
Now he's got there's a big takedown.
Verdum's going for the choke.
He escapes from the arm triangle. Good punch.
Fabricio Verdum is continuing to punish that eye.
Yes, he is. That's a good target for him. He sees the swelling, and it's going to impede his opponent's vision. Nice shot. Look at this.
Combination by the champion.
Man, he connects with the right and the left.
And there's a takedown attempt. He's really doing a good job of controlling distance and getting off these shots.
Oh, nice takedown by the Brazilian, Fabricio Verdum.
It looks like he may be attempting a submission here. He's got to get out of the half guard, separate the legs. Separates the leg, pops out of half guard. Now he's in side control.
That's pretty tight, Mike.
That's nasty.
This is bad to watch. Incredible! Just absolutely incredible!
Fabricio Verdum by submission!
He got the choke for the tap.
Joe, here's the finish on our fight replay.
Tremendous pressure here. You can see on this arm triangle. Cinches it in tight. And gets the victory. And here it is again. Beautiful arm triangle submission, absolutely perfectly executed. And one more time, nice technique here on this submission.
Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Gaines called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 23 seconds of the third round, declaring the winner by tap out and new undisputed UFC heavyweight champion of the world, Fabricio Vicavallo.
Fabricio Vicavallo Verdum is the new UFC heavyweight champion. What a great night of fights. For my partner, Joe Rogan, this is Mike Goldberg saying so long until next time. We see you right back here inside the Octagon. From me, knuckle up your tools from me, uppercut it, cut it, make them double up and move funny. Try to press your luck, you might end up a chump who pulls something. I'm laying in the cut, pushing all your buttons, slipping punches, trying to pull something. Give me that.